Hi there, my name is Dan, and this is a free extract from my larger InDesign course on my website, bringyourownlaptop.com. Hi there, in this video we're going to look at creating dotted lines and like dashed lines, perforation lines. We're going to do wavy lines and stripy lines and all sorts of lines. So let's go and do that now. Alright, so to put the border around the outside, we're going to start with the rectangle. So the rectangle tool, not the rectangle frame tool. Okay, the rectangle tool. And what I'd like to do is, you saw earlier that I had it kind of like perfectly away from the edge now. What I can do is I can draw it exactly the right size. Remember, that is actually the edge of the page. This bit on the outside here is the bleed, remember. Okay, so I'm going to draw it the actual size, okay, my half letter. Okay, so it's a nice big rectangle. Now we've got a fill of green and a stroke of nothing. So what I would like to do, actually I'll leave it there for the moment just while we're practicing this, because if I grab my selection tool and I try and scale it down proportionately, what are the keys? That's right, Command and Shift on a Mac and Control and Shift on a PC. And if I hold them down, right, and I make them proportionately smaller, okay, you'll notice that if I put it here in the middle, it's actually kind of, it doesn't scale the way we want. We want equal distances around the outside. So if I scale it down even more, come on, you can see it's a lot bigger on the sides than it is in the top and the bottom, just because it's scaling that way. So what I'd like to do is I'm going to undo, so it actually fills the outside. And what we can do, you can see at the top here, it's got a width and height. It's perfect. Okay, matches my half letter. What I can do in here is some basic math. Okay, these little boxes, any of these little white boxes, you can do some little math in, which is really handy. So in here, I can go minus, and I'm going to turn half an inch. Okay, so 0.5. And you'll see it just sucked it in half. Half an inch. Do the same in here, minus 0.5. You can do times. Okay, if I did times 2. Okay, so it'll be times 2 inches. It's that little asterisk. Okay, and it's a whole lot taller than it needs to be. So I'm going to undo. So I'm going to go minus 0.5. Minus, plus, all that sort of stuff works. And to get it in the middle, you could use your line tools. There's mine up the top here, or there's a panel that we saw earlier. But actually, it's just easier to grab your black arrow, click hold, and you'll notice that it just kind of snaps. You see those two purple pinky lines just kind of like saying, hey, there's the middle. And you'll see visually it looks like it's in the middle. So it's actually 0.5, half an inch from all the sides, and it looks nice and perfect. So now to make the line dotted. Okay, so we're going to give it no fill. So I clicked on my fill, I'm going to get a none. And this one here, the stroker on the outside, I'm going to make it white or paper. Okay, and this is the stroke here. Okay, how thick it is. At the moment, it's 1 point. It's probably what I want, but let's make it nice and big just as an example so we can all see what we're doing. So bump it up to 4 points. And now we need to find our stroke panel. If you can't find it, mine's there. Hello. Okay, but if you can't find yours, go to Window, go down to Stroke and turn it on. Now yours might look a little different as well. Yours might be. There's a little fly-up menu that says Hide Options. And if yours looks like mine, you've got really basic control, click on this option and say Show Options. You get the big, ugly version with all the details that we need. Okay, and the one we need the moment is Type. Okay, that's going to allow us to change it from a solid line like we know it to all these other options. There's some weird ones, okay? Ones that I've never used, Thick Thin, you might like them. Okay, White Diamond, never used. Dotted lines and dashed lines are the ones we're going to look at the moment. And there's two kinds of dotted. Okay, there's dotted, and for some reason the Japanese like their dots a little bit closer together. Okay, Japanese thing, not sure. But, okay, so there's my dots around the outside. If you want a dashed, okay, there's dashed. There's a ugly squirrely line. You might like the squirrely line. Right hash. There's some weird things in there, okay? But we're going to go to dotted, and we're going to put the size down, okay, to something, I don't know. I'm putting 2 points. Dashed lines. Now, you might use dashed lines as a visual thing like I'm doing here. There's nothing. This dotted line's just for pretty sake. Okay, what we're gonna do is maybe it's a snip here, you know, the scissors, like cut this bit off for the redeem you coupon. Okay, what you can do is, instead of doing it for this rectangle, you can do the exact same tricks with just a straight line. Okay, this straight line here I can draw. Okay, and what I might do actually is draw it straight up and down. If you wanna draw a line straight up and down, it's the similar technique we did when we made a circle. Remember, we held down shift and it was a perfect circle. That same technique makes it a perfect line. So if I hold down shift before I start dragging it out, you can see it kind of really wants to go up, straight up and down. So say that's gonna be my perforation line where I want people to snip it off. It's got a fill. A line can't have a fill. Okay, and the line around the outside is gonna be white. Okay, I'm gonna make it 2 points just so you can see it. And then you can see the exact same controls. Hey, somebody's calling. Okay, let's go to dash lines. Dashed. All right. I'm going to pause there. Go check the phone. I'll be right back. All right, so I'm back. And this dotted line here, okay, this dashed line, sorry, I don't need it. So I've selected it with my black arrow and just hit delete on my keyboard. Just tap the key on your keyboard and it's gone. All right, dashed lines, dotted lines, wavy lines, curly lines, all of that. Okay, let's move on to our next video. So what did you think? Did you like it? Okay, if you did, please hit the like button and maybe consider subscribing to my channel. It really helps my business. Now, this is just a free video from my larger InDesign course. You can see the full version on bringyourownlaptop.com. On that site, there is a free cheat sheet you can download. Okay, print it off, stick it next to your computer, look awesome. The other thing is I have lots of other courses there. Photoshop, Illustrator, InDesign, After Effects, Premiere, Dreamweaver, lots of other ones. So go check that out on bringyourownlaptop.com. Bye.